So what's up, athletes? Freeletics is all about sweat, but in between exercises during the rest time, this is where we have time to think and drink a little bit of water.
And that's exactly what we're gonna do now. In this quiz battle are different questions coming from you guys, and we're gonna answer them now.
Okay, so the first question is, what pull-up bar should I use? That's a pretty good one. Let me give them the bottle back. Okay, all right. So what pull-up bar should I use? So there's a lot of different pull-up bars on the market, right? And let's just break it down in two big main families. So there's the wall-mounted pull-up bars, which you put on your wall, which are securely mounted. And then you have different types of door frame pull-up bar, some that are securely mounted, some that are not mounted, some that go in between the frame itself, and some that are hooked on the frame. With this in mind, actually, what you have to think about next is what are your goals, right? And which exercises can you perform onto which type of pull-up bar? So a wall-mounted pull-up bar normally is one that is much more secure, that has much more space behind and in front of the bar, and that is normally placed in a position in your apartment or house with more clearance underneath the bar and more clearance above the bar, right? So in these types of pull-up bars, you could do pretty much any kind of pulling exercises, even a muscle-up, for instance, which needs you to kip and to actually pull yourself up to the bar and then above the bar, right? But if you have a doorframe pull-up bar, which is probably what most of the people have, you will probably not be able to do these types of exercises at home. But that is not really a problem because there's a lot of things that you can do with a doorframe pull-up bar at home. So you can adapt a lot of exercises. So for example, if you have a strict muscle-up or even like a hanging knee raise, okay? Even though in the Freeletics app, the people start with like a fully extended body underneath the bar, that doesn't mean that you cannot perform these exercises at home. You will need a little bit of creativity, but what you will most likely have to do is to bend your knees and perform the exercises from that position. The pull-up bar that you should use should be based on what you can actually realistically implement at your place and your goals, right? And if you cannot perform your goal exercises at home, that doesn't mean that you should let yourself be stopped from buying a pull-up bar, right? Any pull-up bar is better than no pull-up bar. And there's a lot of things that you can do at home that can help you progress on your goal exercises. And some of these exercises will just have to be performed elsewhere, in the park, for instance, or at the gym, okay? So don't let that get into the way of what you can and cannot perform. You have to be creative, change the exercises around, and work your way up to your goals.
What kind of shoes should I wear when training? Okay. Okay, so that's a good question. Basically, I think three main types of training here. First category would be running. Obviously, if you want to running, you want to have a running shoe, which means a shoe with some cushioning and rather light. On the other hand, if you're into weight training, you want to have the opposite. So a shoe with no cushioning and rather flat, so that it's very stable when you're going to lift weights. And then, in between those two types of practices, I would say the vast majority of us, what we're going to do, we're not specialized either into running or weights. We kind of do a little bit of many different practices. So we want to have a shoe which is quite versatile and with which we can do many different things. So according to what you prefer, you want to have a shoe which is maybe either a little bit light or more stable, depending on your preferences. If what you're doing is, I don't know, for example, sit-ups, push-ups and squats, well, even barefoot could be totally fine.
All right. What kind of jump rope is best? I will need one jump rope. Thank you, Thomas. Yep. Thank you very much. Okay, so what kind of jump rope is best? There are lots of jump rope on the market, But I personally recommend if you're performing a lot of repetitions and you want to integrate jump rope in your workouts very regularly, to buy a speed rope. And why do I recommend the speed rope? It's because it's actually very light. It's also very thin, so it's very easy to clear. You can actually fold it in any which way you want to make it very compact, so then you can train at home or train outside, bring it everywhere without even feeling it in your backpack, right? And it also has a lot of advantages, such as it spins very well at the end hole because there are ball bearings here that helps with the rotation. And also in the handles, normally you can adjust the cable to whichever length you want for your height or everything. Because it's also light, if you're performing a lot of repetitions and you're using that regularly, it's also it's a bit more easier than other more heavier and classic jump ropes for your wrist and your shoulders. Although, if you're a beginner though, it's probably not the best idea to start with this right off the bat because the speed rope is quite light. You might lack a little bit of feedback of the beginning, knowing where the jump rope is, right, when you're jumping. So for these reasons, I would advise a beginner or a novice that doesn't really know yet if he wants to integrate a jump rope regularly in his workouts to maybe purchase a heavier type of jump rope to get familiar with the jump rope and the feedback that you actually need to be able to clear the rope at almost every rep. And then once you've decided actually that you want to integrate jump rope more consistently and regularly into your workout routine, then you probably should think about a speed rope.
All right. Which box should I use? All right, so as you have seen in some of our exercise videos, some of them require you to use a box. We could categorize those exercises in two main categories. First, when this box is only used as a support, for example, decline push-ups, incline push-ups, split squats. In those exercises, you don't really need to have a proper box as the one we show in the videos. You can use whatever you have. A bench, a chair, a couch, or even stairs. In the second category, we have exercises like box step-ups, box jumps, burpee box jumps. For those exercises, you really want to have something which is very stable and where you can confidently land on that object. The most obvious solution would be to have a box similar to the one we have in the videos. Those boxes are heavy, they do not move when you land on them, and also the dimensions are standardized. If you do not have such a box, anything stable could be fine, for example, a bench, which you could easily find in a park. So in conclusion, try to understand how that box helps you perform that exercise. Is it only here to support part of your body, or do you have to land on that object?
Which barbell and weight plates are best for the barbell training journeys? Well, actually, we don't need any kind of specific barbell or plates for these training journeys. What you need is really just a barbell with plate that fits that barbell. But the most important thing is that you have a wide enough range of weights so that you can actually progress your strength over time from week to week or from month to month, right? You don't want to be stuck with very few set of weight plates, for instance, with a big gap, so that you're forced to use these bigger weights that you can probably not lift or have to wait too long enough to be able to progress your strength to the next level.
All right, let's see what we have next. I don't have a pole. Is there something else I can use? All right, so as you've seen in some of our videos, we sometimes use a pole in some exercises like leg swings, dragon flags, assisted pistols. Obviously, it's somehow kind of a gold standard to perform those exercises, but you don't have to only use a pole in order to perform those. And actually, most likely, most of us do not have a pole at home. So don't be afraid to be creative. For example, for assisted pistol, you can definitely use a door frame. Most of the time, it's going to be good enough. For leg swings, only even a wall is going to be fine. And for the dragon flag, you can use any object you can grip as long as it's not going to move while performing the exercise.
All right, so these were all the questions we had for today, unless maybe you have another one, Thomas?
Well, personally, I don't, but if you have any further questions, let us know in the comments down below.
Cool. Well, then we'll see you next time. Thanks for watching.